We are bringing you to Monterola and Rio Maggiore, a couple of the nicest villages in Italy's Cinque Terre. Starting in Monterola and continuing to Rio Maggiore. Arriving by train, you will find that there's a short walk from the Monterola train station through a little pedestrian tunnel that goes under the tracks, and in a few minutes you will walk through town to the beautiful azure shores of the Mediterranean. Before heading downhill from the rail tracks, you can walk uphill a little bit into the village itself proper, and there you'll find more shops and a few little restaurants, cafes, and maybe go shopping for some t-shirts or aprons or anything that would say Cinque Terre or Monterola. Take a look. UNESCO has designated this entire coastline as a World Heritage Area. They say the Ligurian coast between Cinque Terre and Porto Venere is a cultural landscape of great scenic and cultural value. The layout and disposition of the small towns and the shaping of the surrounding landscape, overcoming the disadvantages of a steep, uneven terrain, encapsulate the continuous history of human settlement in this region over the past millennium. They don't have a beach, but there is a boat ramp carved into the stone, the most popular spot around, for it functions like a beach, packed with sunbathers. In the summer, the ramp leads to a cove with good swimming, further protected by a stone jetty, and ladders to help people get in and out of the water. Monterola is another one of the beautiful towns of Cinque Terre. And when you get to Monterola, you want to walk through the village and walk to the boat ramp and be sure to walk out to the point where we're standing now to get this vista. Looking back, you see the pastel-colored cubic buildings just spilling down the hillside. It's really quite a wonderful sight. You don't see this when you're in the town, so you really need to get out of the town. So when you're out here in Monterola, you want to go along the pathway and get a beautiful view looking back at the town. When you're in the town, it's a little hard to see all of the buildings and see how pretty it is, but out here at this point, it's a wonderful vista.
This is the angle.
This is the one.
Beautiful, that's beautiful. It. Kisses from Brazil.
Cinque Terre is a national park in Italy, and their official website has some very interesting information that we're going to share with you describing the park. Today in Italy, there are 22 national parks set up.
Monterola.
And two more parks waiting for implementation. Altogether, the parks cover 1.5 million hectares, equivalent to about 5% of the national territory of Italy. The Cinque Terre National Park has, compared to the varied panorama of the other parks, some unusual elements that make it unique. In fact, the Cinque Terre Park, with just 4,226 acres, is the smallest national park in Italy, and at the same time, the most densely populated, with about 5,000 residents shared out in five villages. The villages of Rio Maggiore, Monterola, Cornelia, Vernazza, and Monte Rosso al Mare. What makes special this area rather than others, however, is the fact that here the natural environment has been profoundly altered by man's activity. When you're in the middle of Monterola Village, you have this nice view looking up the main street. There's actually a stream underneath that was covered over back in the 1950s, so that it makes a very nice walkway. And of course, there's restaurants and cafes along there, some gift shops and souvenir shops. There is a nice selection of pizzerias and takeout food, or of course, the ever-present pasta. You could pick up picnic supplies or sit in one of the many terrace restaurants here. The most basic Italian food is focaccia, not much more than bread with some olive oil and salt. If you're a ceramics fan, you'll be delighted shopping in Italy. Even in the tiny village, they have a major ceramic shop filled with colorful items. and a lot of residences up on the hillside. There's about 1,000 people living here during the high season especially. And you can stay in Monterola. There's some bed and breakfasts here. There's some little hotels. Nice little restaurants will take care of you. Of course, there are no cars in town, so you're walking along on a pedestrian lane, hardly a street. And you notice that in this off-season, it's mostly locals out here. So walking along, you really feel like you're part of the local life. Some friendly hounds just saying hello. They are not threatening in any way. Their master is giving them a free leash, and these guys are very well behaved. Consider a few more concepts from the National Park Statement of Purposes. The Cinque Terre National Park has developed guidelines for the development of a model now widely adopted, that of sustainable development. According to the classical definition of the World Tourism Organization, defining sustainable tourism, quote, tourism development that meets the needs of present tourists and host regions while protecting and enhancing at the same time opportunities for the future. The outdoor photo display reminds us of the cultural history and the importance of the vineyards up on the hillsides and all of the handwork that made it possible. Through the tunnel again to the train station for our departure. It's very convenient. The station is right next to the village. Only takes about 5 minutes to get from the town over to the platform real quick. You'll see quite a few trains do come through this little station. It can be a busy place at certain times of day. Some of the trains don't stop. They're intercity expresses. Sometimes there's a freight train that comes rumbling through. Other times it's your train and you want to be sure to get on it going in the correct direction. You can check the schedules. They're posted at the train station, or ask to see if you can get a little copy, a little piece of paper they might hand out to you that helps in planning your day's activities. If you can get hold of this printed schedule, you can time your visits very nicely and know how long you can spend in a town and what time you should get back up to the train platform. However, finding the schedule is a little tricky. You can ask at the stations and they might be able to help you, but it's a pretty hard thing to find online. And it does change from year to year and season to season. The small village of Rio Maggiore is at the southern end of the beautiful collection of villages called Cinque Terre in the Ligurian shores of Italy. Here you see the five towns of Cinque Terre with Rio Maggiore at the bottom. It's a nice little village with several lanes that we'll be exploring in today's program. And we have many movies about the other villages of Cinque Terre. Getting to Rio Maggiore is actually quite easy, and yet it's unusual because there is no road that comes here.
Yeah.
You come by train generally. That's a very easy way to arrive because the train service is frequent and it brings you to the station. And here they have got a gift shop and one of the headquarters of the national parks. And you can buy a map, a t-shirt. If it's in the busy season, you buy a ticket to come into the park. There's a slightly confusing and complicated map posted to help you get your bearings. Essentially, we're going to be walking through a tunnel from the station into the main lane and then down to the waterfront. This tunnel is very convenient because it cuts under a hill that stands between the station and the town. Each one of the five villages has a similar tunnel. And notice how they have decorated the tunnel very nicely. It's very clean and well lit and very safe. As you come out of the train tunnel, you can either go left and walk upslope a little bit into the village proper, or you could just take a right and go downstairs to the lower village, right down to the waterfront. Up to you, depending on your timing. In our case, we're taking a stroll up inland from the train tracks to see as much of the village as we can. There's a sign that says don't sit, but the little local girl can certainly sit as she pleases. It's really a flower stand. and there's little shops. There's folks living here. You see the laundry hanging out the windows and beautiful pastel color buildings. It's got patina of age. There's a little bit of peeling paint here and there, but they do take care of the buildings quite nicely. They keep the place very clean. A view of the next town along the coast, Manarola, clinging to its rocky point. These are the closest two villages in the Cinque Terre. It only takes about 20 minutes to walk down to Manarola. One of the main activities anywhere you go is people watching. And here it's the locals watching the tourists and the tourists watching the locals as we walk on by. It's really got an authentic character here in town, especially in the off season as we're traveling. Nice fresh fruits and vegetables at the farmer's market. If you're here in the summer, it is quite a bit busier. Now we're going down the steps under the train tracks to the lower part of town, where we connect right away with the waterfront through another tunnel. The village is so densely packed that they have tunnels through the buildings and narrow alleyways and steps that lead us right down to the little tiny boat harbor. It's really so small, they keep the boats up on dry land rather than leaving them out in the water bobbing around. So you can see all the boats are stacked up. It's not really the boating season, so there's not a lot of fishing activity going on right now. And the ferry boats are not running in the off season. But there's plenty for us to look at, that's for sure. It's really a colorful little cove down here. And the buildings are kind of beat up and old. They're about 400 years old, but people do take good care of them. And there's residences that are right here in the little harbor front. And of course, you're going to see cats anytime you've got a marine village, nautical environment. Beautiful view from the point. So when you get to Rio Maggiore, you've got to walk to the waterfront and then up the little staircase on the left side. And that's where you gain this beautiful view looking back. The hillside covered with these pastel colored apartments. It looks like a cubist painting. Really gorgeous. And this is a town, a real town where people live. In the winter, there's probably about 500 people living here. In the summer, population goes up to about 1,500. It gets quite crowded with tourists in the summer, of course. If you come in the off season, it's even nicer. In the summertime, people are swimming in the little cove, and that boat ramp is kind of like a beach for sunbathing, but for locals as well as for visitors. But not now. We're here visiting in the month of November. October's also a great time to come here. Or, of course, February, April. It never gets bitter cold, but it gets sunny, and then the sun will go away. The weather changes pretty quickly around here, too. It's always so colorful to see the laundry hanging out in front of these pastel-colored cubic piles tumbling down to the sea. What a vista. You have to walk out to that little point to get the view, and it's certainly worthwhile. And then we took a bit of a detour. Now, this may not be advised for most visitors. We thought we'd climb up these little alleyways. Turns out they're all staircases rather than alleyways. Well, after all, it's built in a steep little valley. So here we go, we're climbing. Some of us not too happy about it, but we're climbing to see where it will end. And it kept going up higher and higher. And we got up and had a different sort of view into the residential district. Again, most visitors will not bother with that detour. So suit yourself. It's not that serious a climb, but it can be strenuous. And you get up there, and then you're looking down at the train station. And that's probably where you want to be to get out of here. So now you're going to have to go down some steps to get back down to the train. It would have been easier to just simply walk up the main street of the village, and that connects directly with the level of the train tracks, but we climbed and we made it. We conquered the hill, and now we're resting, getting our pictures. And that's the pathway that we want to walk on, but we have to get back down to its level. Then we discovered there's the elevator up there. So that made things quite a bit easier. We were able to ride down instead of walk down. When you get back down to the train station, you now have a choice. You can either hop on the next train and ride out of here and onto the next village, perhaps down to Monterola, or you could walk it if the path is open. It's been undergoing some repairs on and off in recent years, but you check it out. And if the pathway is open, as it was for us on this visit, it's only a 20-minute walk and it's very level. This is the easiest walk between any of the five villages. It's called the Via Amore, the Way of Love. There was a terrible storm in 2011 that really flooded the villages and wiped out this walkway. Landslides came down from up above and it was pretty much destroyed. And they've been rebuilding it for a couple of years. So you check when you're there at Cinque Terre to see if the walkway has reopened. And if so, hopefully, you'll be able to make that very pleasant walk. As you see, it's all level. This is 20 minutes, the easiest walk between the villages. There are mountain trails that connect the other villages of Cinque Terre. And you can tune in to our other episodes and we'll take you on a walk up in those mountains. We have a lot more episodes about the villages of Cinque Terre as part of our 1,000 movie package covering the great highlights of Europe. We do have many more movies about Cinque Terre that you can find on our YouTube channel. We upload a new movie every week, so please subscribe to our channel. Then you'll be notified. And if you enjoyed the movie, how about a thumbs up? And we always welcome comments down below. It really helps us spread the word. Thank you.